Hello everyone, it's Saxy Jojo, back to Bad Habits again. It's like past midnight. I should probably be asleep and whatnot, but I'm not. Instead I'm up, cause it's time for some Starbot. I actually don't remember where we were at last, so yeah. I think we were about to board a train. I think that was it. I don't know. We'll find out in a second. Hey, aye, what we doing? Thanks for watering my plants. You can keep that watering can. You never know when you'll see a sad plant. What? The inner satellite train is in the south part of town. Okay, cool. So I guess we just go. And we're going to board a train. I was sort of mistaken. Okay. Hey friend, I have my ticket. Show my ticket. Welcome aboard. This is a weird train, yo. Like, we got a night sky and stuff that way. On the satellite. Wait, I'm on a satellite though. Do I get to do anything? I just have to wait. Okay. Something's happening. This is weird. I visited my cousin here today from another satellite. I have never seen so many roofs before. Okay? Is there something this way? No. Is there something this way? And no. Darn. I guess I go up these stairs. Oh, it didn't matter what stairs I go up. Alright, what's the sign say? Sign, give me a sign. Tower satellite. I guess it's this one. What was it like there for? I don't remember. Hey, you come talk to me. The houses on the satellite are built on top of each other because there is no roof anymore. It's like a city of roofs. There are houses many layers below that are starting to collapse. Humans and stars are collapsing too. What will be left? That's a good question, yo. What will be left? How do I know I'm going in the right direction? The door lock? It's locked. I called it. Oh, you're trying to trap it. My neighbor hasn't been feeling well, so I bought her some pills. But now I'm sick, and I can't take them to her right now. Could you take this bouquet for me? Sure. Thank you. Seed bouquet. Do-do-do-do-do-do! And I guess if I find some lady in need of a flower, I'll give it to her. Alright, you need some flowers! One day, I bet even the stars will have to be man-made. Can you imagine robotic stars? Robotic stars. The stars are dying too, kiddo. Who knows how long the robots will last, though. That's kind of depressing. I kind of want to see if you have anything else to say. Go back in the house. I need to know if he has any other. No, you don't have anything else to say. Darn. That's kind of dreadful because I actually liked your bit of dialogue. It's a bit dark. Do I go this way? No, I don't go that way. Do I go this way? I guess not. Where do I go? Unless it was another door that I missed. Probably that. What's this? What's this? No. That's not what I need, apparently. Oh, is that you, Ami? Come in. Well, I thought you were my neighbor. She was sick, so she told me to give you these flowers. Oh, a bouquet of roses. They're so pretty. Here, why don't you take one for your troubles? Thank you. Obtained white rose. It's pretty. Kind of looks like you. You're like white flower. You're like white flower. Oh, man. Ah! I like white flowers. Ooh, paper. I'm gonna be snooping. Time to snoop. There's a card on the table. Get well soon. Hearts are drawn all over the page. Aw, that's so nice. Do you have anything interesting to say? Hey buddy, don't die. I hope she feels better soon. She's very sweet. It's strange. I can still smell her here. I don't think that's how noses are supposed to work, but okay. Anything else? No, you just say the same thing over again and slightly creep me out with the fact that you could smell your neighbor. So, hey friend. Hey, no, talk to me. Stop walking weird. Even though you don't talk much, you light up when you look at that star. I didn't know robots could do that. You try to say, you just say the same big dialogue. Why is... I just walked across these roofs. Okay, what do you have to say? Oh, that's a star you have there. May I look at it? I'm an expert on space. An expert? Can you teach us how to find more stardust? Is that so? What does that mean? Shh, robot, I'm thinking. I'm an expert. He's an expert on noisy thinking. This is a very strange star. I cannot tell how old it is or where it comes from. It doesn't look very normal. It has quite a unique composition, I believe. That is my expert analysis. What does composition mean? It is what makes up something. Stars are made out of dead stars. That just took a really dark turn really quickly. Even we are made from stars. What? Do you grow people from dead stars? Of course not. It's more complex than that. It has taken me many years to become an expert. Oh, you must be very smart. Could you help me with finding stardust and growing stars? I'm only an expert on space. Perhaps you should look for a stardust expert. This expert turned out to be not very useful at all. Even space sloths are more helpful. I don't know about that last part now, because that stuff was pretty freaky. Just looking at them kind of made me just like, no, please no. There's a drawing of a hat. Okay, I guess that's all for that. You should probably raid your fridge for all your food, but I'm not. I don't know why the quality just looks better. I don't know. Stop ignoring me. Lately, my plants have been looking very sad. That's it? I took the time to try to talk to you, even though you walked away from me, and that's all you have to say? Can't, but what's in this book first? I want to write a letter, but I ran out of paper. Yo, that's the struggle right there. What's down here? Oh, it's a person. No, walk away from me. I need to talk to you. I swear to how come cats can eat the same thing every day and lick their own asses and people think they're cute AF but not people? The way Gordon Ramsay handles those eggs, you think he's raising his own kids. I've only pooped my pants twice, and that's an accomplishment, I think. Okay then, we got some interesting dialogue. Black book, pink field, something's wrong, fresh fruit. Oh, these are songs! Who are wondering, I'm trying to keep these playthroughs as like clean as possible. So possibly can, like, if I can avoid saying certain words, I'll do it. Petra, Claudia. Oh, hello. I'm naming stars. There's so many that don't have names yet. How sad. I don't want them to be forgotten before they die. Does your star have a name? Let me ask. Do you have a name? A name? A word everyone can call you. You can call me the word Star. Its name is Star. That's not unique at all. Let's give it another name. It will be special. Can I give you another name? What do I need for it? It will make you unique among all the other stars. You're pretty important. Oh, why don't you choose a name? Me? Yes. I would like that. Let me think. Oh, I get to name the star. And I have, like, 12 spaces to think of a really good name. I'm assuming you're genderless, so that means I can give you like any name, male or female, it'd still be okay. Do 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 do. Well, seeing as you're going to die and you are a star, you're going to eventually make up another star. I will call you Yoko. No. Or I can name that ship. Should I? No, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that. You're going to be named Yokai. Yokai? Yes, thank you. I like how that sounds. You better like how it sounds. It wasn't up for debate, kid. What's your name? I'm the president. President of what? Of the satellite. How'd you become president? I own a key that can open any door. Isn't it like a janitor, though? That sounds useful. How'd you get it? It doesn't matter. I'm an important president. That sounds illegal. That sounds very, very illegal. How'd you get this key? I'm not telling you. You don't need to know this information. I have people that will hunt you down and kill you. Don't try me, kid. You should bow to me. No, no. I guess I should do recess. What now? You are pardoned. Pardoned? From what? Death! Oh, good. Good. Aren't you gonna ask what I pardoned you for? You have told me I was pardoned from death. Yes, but you were condemned to death because you crossed this threshold. Be gone before I condemn you to death for crossing this threshold again. What a strange man. He is a president. President? Like a king. Do you have a king? No, I do not have a king or a president. You have both? No, you only have one. It's a type of ruler. What do you measure a king or a president? Justice, I suppose? This president has been very just to me so far. We should leave before I'm condemned again. Thank you, sir. Okay, so there's not really any unique dialogue going on there. But we have a star name, Yokai! He'll be Yokai will be rocking with us. I don't know why I just did that. Alright, up we go. Yes. I wonder what happens when robots are turned off. Is it just like sleep? Or death that's sort of temporary, you know? I don't know. When my batteries run out, and I suddenly just drop off the face of the planet, you'll know. I've never met an egg that has told such funny jokes. What? What's with these people and eggs? I don't understand. No hable española. Can't sleep. I keep wondering what's going to happen. Sounds like my life. Except I just don't sleep because I don't sleep. Okay, so like this was not where I need to go. What's down here? I'm curious. Did I already come to you? I feel like I did. I went to write. Yeah, I did come. I came and talked to you. Just am scrammed. Alright, in here. Hey, bud. I like sharing stories. Would you like to read a story? Oh, yes, please. Yes, I'd like that. I have several stories. Which story would you like to hear? Let's hear the one with the ocean. This story is about a child who went to sail the ocean. The ocean? What is that? It's a large body of water, I think. A body? It is a person then? No, it's like a tub, except much larger. Here, there's a picture. Look, there are stars in the sky and water. That is a lot of water. Anyway, here's the child on the boat. The boat traveled for a long, long time through stormy waters and calm, sunny seas. The child landed occasionally, staying only for a few days at a time on islands before taking off again. After a long journey, the boat approached the end of the world. Beyond the advancing horizon, the water spilled out into the endless space. The young adventurer peered over the edge with great fear before their ship plunged over the edge of the planet and into the vast darkness. The boat heaved and rocked, carried on relentlessly by the water as it rushed through the heavens. The young seafarer rowed anxiously to avoid stray debris, nearly avoiding collision after collision. Finally, the water slowed and the adventurer gazed over the edge at the stars below. The boat sailed leisurely on the space river through the galaxy far beyond. The young adventurer admired the star-dotted heavens above and below with great satisfaction. This was home at last. The end. That sounds really wonderful. I would like to go to the stars. I would love that too. Well, you are a star, yokai. Yokai, you're a star. Don't. The story is about a child who climbs a mountain. A mountain? It is like a vast stretch of land that reaches high into the sky. Here is a picture. Oh, I see. I don't think there are many of those around here. The child lived in a small village at the base of the mountain and often liked to stargaze at night. One day, the youth decided to go to the nearest moon and collect stars. They packed all evening and set out in the morning to climb the mountain. The journey was fairly easy at first. The young adventurer climbed the foothills and began to follow the winding trails up the side of the mountain. By night, however, the path was becoming steep, and at times the child feared falling over the edge. Swallowing fear, they looked to the stars and followed them until finally they reached the top. The child had never seen so far in their life, the vast land stretching far, far away, until it was lost in the horizon. Above, a plump moon hung from sky, bright and inviting. Climbing a tree, the child jumped with all their might onto the moon. The child was surprised, however, to find another child there already. The child's skin was ghastly white, so that it was hard to see them against the moon's light. The ghostly child was reaching up into the sky and plucking stars and rearranging them in a bright garden that gave the moon its light. The young adventurer admired the bright garden and offered to help. The moon inhabitant accepted, happy to have a friend who appreciated and could share their work. Together, they continued to tend to the moon garden for many years, content to work for the next generation of celestial gardeners for relief. The end. A garden, huh? That sounds really cool. Which story would you like to hear? The one with the forest. This story is about a forest. A forest? What is that? It is a place with lots of trees growing together. Oh, I think I can imagine that. I'm not really sure what that means. Here's a picture. It's so pretty. This forest has trees that grow stars. Oh, it's beautiful. Anyway, in this forest was a small village. The people climbed the trees to pluck the ripe stars from the tree branches at night, planting their gardens with these seeds by morning. But one year, a careless traveler dropped a torch in the night, setting the forest ablaze. The villagers escaped, but their homes and stars were left to ashes after several days of burning. A child among them, upset by the catastrophe, set out across the scared landscape alone. For a long time, they saw only the blackened corpses of the trees twisted in agony. But after a few days, they came to the edge of the burnt ruins, finding a meadow. The meadow turned into a short growth which soon grew into another forest. The young adventurer had never seen such a dark forest before. However, they continued on anxiously. The trees pressed in closer, becoming thicker, towered higher. It had become so dense that the adventurer had no choice but to climb. They ascended carefully through the web of branches, scaling twisted limbs. These trees reached higher than even the star forest, and the adventurer soon realized that the canopy nestled in the lower rings of the heavens. Poking their heads out, the adventurers saw the hilly tops of trees into the long distance. Not too far above, the stars hung. They reached out and began to carefully pull them into their bag. 5, 10, 20. The young traveler filled their pack and soon began their descent. The journey back was faster, lighter, and the adventurer arrived home, surrounded by curious villagers. The child opened their pack, and the villagers, elated, scattered the new stars into the soil. In a few years, the star forest began to grow again, and the young adventurer was greatly celebrated in the village. The end. How wonderful. I hope someday I can find more stardust to grow stars for everyone here to see.
Oh, there's nothing in the mailbox.
Oh, that... it's locked. Do I have to go talk to the mayor? No, I just got through with story time. Ooh, how did I get to him again? This way? No. It was not this way. I have to go in some other direction. Was it this way? No, I feel like it was like, it was this way, that way, it was some way. Oh Lord, where was he? Come on, brother. What do you guys think of the story? Of those three stories? Like, any particular things that came to mind? Any thoughts? Hey, buddy, pal, amigo, I kinda need your key. I'm better than this before. Oh, I always pardon you again. Thank you, sir. Okay, so that's not. Okay, I thought that's what I needed to do. Thought, you know, if I found. I don't want to talk to her again because she has a mouth. Then again, my mouth isn't so clean either. I just want to keep. I'm gonna keep it clean for this. This is gonna stay as clean as I could possibly make it. Do 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 do. Stars have been disappearing. Oh wait, I missed the. Do you need dialogue? Wait 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 wait. Talk to me, friendo. Talk to me. Can't sleep. Okay. No 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 no. That's not the interesting part. It's been getting darker lately. The stars have been disappearing. I'm scared that when I wake up, they will be gone. Boom. This is not where I need to go. Just do some weird animal screeching. Crap, I can't remember what. There was one story that I wanted to like talk about, but I can't remember which one it was. And the door's locked. What do I do? I don't know what to do. I noticed that they all have similar. Phil, do I talk to you? No, because you're out of paper. You can't help me. You're not a story writer. You're not a novelist. Boy. Or a comfort point, what are you? No, I don't need your expert opinion. I didn't even read that dialogue, but I feel so bad now. Okay, no. Alright. Let's start. Like, digging the music, though. Digging the music. Hey, buddy. Pal. I tried to wish my name, but I've. Wait, wait, wait. I tried to wish my neighbor well yesterday, but she got me sick. I wonder if it's because I gave her a kiss when she fell asleep. Oh, don't tell her that, though. I won't. Huh. Found a love note. It's okay if you're too sad to do anything today. I brought some crepes, and if you want, I can hold your hand until you sleep. Hey, crepes. That's like my college addiction. Okay, so I don't know what I'm supposed to do. So I'm gonna end the gameplay here. And what I'm going to do is I'll figure it out. And then when I figure out what exactly I'm supposed to be doing or what I'm missing, I will start this bad boy up again and we will go from there. Like, right from the start, so I'm just gonna chill here. We're gonna say yokai. I wonder if I'll be called Starbuck the entire time. But anyways, I hope you all enjoyed this episode of Starbuck. Yeah, that's about it. Deuces.